Today we're reading from the 5th chapter, verse number 24.
Yonta sukho antararamas tathantar jyotir eva yaha sa yogi brahma nirvanam brahma bhuto adigacchati.
Translation: one whose happiness is within, who is active and rejoices within, and whose aim is inward, is actually the perfect mystic. He is liberated in the Supreme, and ultimately he attains the Supreme. The happiness that all of us are searching for cannot be found in matter. As much as we try, ultimately we will always be frustrated, because there is a fundamental difference between matter and spirit. We being spirit, we are eternal, we live forever. And matter being temporary is not eternal, and it is taken away from us. We are separated from matter. So if we are searching for happiness within matter, one day it will be taken away from us, and at that day we will be in distress, we will be unhappy. So that's why intelligence means to search for that happiness in spiritual objects, in objects which are eternal. In this verse, Lord Krishna is highlighting that the yogis, they learn how to take pleasure within the self. That means Atma. Atmaram. Another name of the Lord is Atmaram. And the devotees also, they are also known as Atmaram, because they take pleasure in spirit, spiritual objects, the soul or God. Both of them are spiritual. The yogi meditates upon the Supreme Lord within his heart in the Paramatma form, and he receives great pleasure and happiness. Take for example Dhruva Maharaj. Dhruva Maharaj, he was searching for material happiness. He wanted a kingdom greater than his father's. He meditated upon the Lord, he performed austerities, and he chanted Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. And within 6 months, Lord Vishnu was pleased and appeared before him in his four-handed form. When he asked Dhruva that, "I am very pleased with your austerities. What do you want? You can ask anything you want." Dhruva Maharaj felt ashamed. He expressed that, "I was searching for pieces of broken glass, but now instead I have found a diamond. What is the value of broken glass when I find a diamond?" Which means Dhruva Maharaj experienced spiritual happiness. He experienced the darshan of the Lord, and just by coming in contact with Lord Vishnu, all of his senses were activated. He was feeling happiness. He was completely free from all distress, miseries, and spiritual happiness. That is the actual happiness we're searching for. A good example is the musk deer. In Hindi, it's called Kasturi Mrig. So the musk deer, he smells some fragrance, some very strong, beautiful fragrance. And he's always searching the whole forest. Where is that fragrance coming from? But actually that fragrance is in his navel. The musk deer have a chemical that is in their navel, and that is the fragrance that they're smelling, and they're searching for it everywhere. Similarly, that happiness that we are searching for is within our heart, is in the service of the Lord, is in reconnecting with the Lord, and that is inside. We don't have to search outside. We don't have to endeavor outside. That is the goal of meditation. That is the goal of chanting japa. That is the goal of studying the scriptures. That is the goal of all of our endeavors, to get that happiness. And having achieved that stage, one becomes detached from material objects and is ready to enter the spiritual world, Vaikuntha or Goloka Vrindavan, where he will serve the Lord and be happy by satisfying the Lord. The Lord's satisfaction is our satisfaction. That is ideal love. If I love someone, my only desire is to satisfy him. If I could just satisfy him, I would feel very happy. And that is where we are going to get our happiness. If we can just satisfy the Lord, then we will feel completely satisfied and tranquil. If Lord Krishna is pleased with that endeavor, then he will reveal himself within our heart. And if we get his darshan, if we get his audience, the self becomes joyful. The self becomes completely satisfied. So he is getting that spiritual happiness. Antar. Antar means within. So we have to become antarmukhi. Antarmukhi means facing inwards.